You have heard the story, I'm sure, many times from me, but a good story is worth repeating about my great-grandmother having three children. My grandma was one, my great-aunt was another, and my uncle, who died at the age of 19, always told he was killed in the war. He died in a bar fighting over a woman. He was stabbed and murdered. I never knew that story until after my great-grandmother died, just after she died. And I'm like, wow, this family always tells stories, don't they? You know, oh, we fought in the war and he did this. And they you know. But the real story really is amazing to me. And it has profoundly affected me. Because after 5 years and 10 years and 15 years and 20 years, each 5 years, she was asked, you know, what do you think? Should he get out of jail? Get on parole? And on year 20, she said yes. He has served enough time. It's time for him to leave. You know, in hearing the story, I would have loved to have asked her, and I will someday in paradise, I would have loved to ask her, why did you pick that year? And why did you say let him go in the first place? He could just rot in hell, yes? You know, my great-grandmother would have told me, and I share with you, that she would have never entered paradise with that on her heart, heavy on her heart. I want him dead. I want him to suffer. I want him punished. She was a very wise woman. God gave her that gift of wisdom. What is it in our heart that will not allow us into the kingdom of heaven? What is it we will not let go of? And it typically is not hurts against us. It's hurts against our children, our parents, family, maybe country. What is it that we, when we stand before God, I will not let go of this. I will not. You have to accept me the way I am. Not in this kingdom, my friend. Not in this kingdom. So, a blessed death, I always think, is those who have time to prepare themselves. Where it's not like, kind of caught me unexpected. Didn't expect that car accident. You know, we're standing in line like, oh, wow, that was a bad accident, wasn't it? And the Lord looks at us, and the Lord says, are you prepared for my kingdom? Are you sorry? I think smart people say yes, and are sincere. But the other question is, do you forgive? Again, smart people say yes. And of course, they mean that. We have in our church the understanding of purgatory. Purgatory, when I was a child, I was taught that purgatory is hell without the devil. That didn't sound good at all. It's like, ooh, hell without the devil. You know, you had some chance you might get yourself out of there, maybe. But as one gets older, and I understood that purgatory, hell is a destination. I'm not anxious for you for that. I'm not. You know, I've always sincerely said this. I've never met a person I thought was going to hell. I've heard a lot of confessions. I've heard a lot of interesting sins. But I never thought someone was going to hell. I think that's because coming to church, I don't think someone destined for hell is coming into a church. They'll be so repulsed by God. It's not so much repulsed by you and me, though they can be, but just repulsed by Christ. Just looking at the crucifix, we see silly movies of people like burning up when they see a cross, right? Kind of silly. But there is something to that. When they come into a church and the presence of God in the Eucharist, they cannot stay here. I'm not talking about people just too lazy to go to church. People who are repulsed by God. Who does that sound like? Satan. But when we die, and let us say, I have not resolved some of this lack of forgiveness. I have not resolved, I'm not sorry for what I did, Lord. I can't imagine saying something like that, but Lord said, okay. You're not an evil person. You're not repulsed by me. We're going to have to spend some time in prayer. And I always think, we will see heaven, will see God, and we want to, in the worst way, embrace God, more than a baby or a child wants to embrace mommy or daddy, we will want to embrace God, and God will say what? Not yet. Not yet. Now, how that process goes on, that part, I'm not sure. I mean, I would presume, again, smart people, Lord, why am I this way? And, Lord, I need your help. I cannot do this alone. Wow. God says, finally, what you could not do in your life, you do now in purgatory. You finally turn to me and ask me for my grace to change. And the other interesting thing, God will say to us, you're listening to me. You're not in charge. You realize that now. You don't have a body. You don't have land. You're somewhere else, and you see me. And so you're asking for my grace. You're acknowledging your sinfulness. And you're saying sorry. Remember, in heaven, there is no time. No more time. In hell, there is no time. There's no time. It will go on forever. In purgatory, I don't want to say you do time, but imagine seeing God so desperately wanting to embrace God and not being allowed to. I would find that almost like hell. To see God, to want to embrace God so bad and not be allowed to because of my sinfulness. I don't know a pain on this world in this world that could match that. So even if it's a few moments, that's going to be painful. I can't imagine stubborn people going through that process for a long time. I can't imagine that happening. I guess there are those who just, you know, this is what I believe, this is what I believe, and God's okay, suit yourself. So it's not the devil. But in a way, it would be very painful, yes? So we pray for those, our beloveds, who have died. And I'm very confident that they enjoy, because it was probably momentary, for those who didn't get to say sorry or kind of let go of their angers. I'm sure it was momentary, but I bet it was painful too. I think we will stand before God, every one of us, and with wisdom and love, tremendous love, more than wisdom, we will have already said to God many times over, I really am sorry. I'm sorry for disappointing you. I'm sorry for not respecting you. I knew better. Not I should have known. No, I knew better, Lord. And even for those few moments, as he's coming to embrace us, I imagine it will be painful. I know it will be for me. Because I will dread these words. You know you disappointed me. I would just dread hearing God say that, yes? You know you disappointed me. Let us stand and pray.